guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be reviewing Photo Stable Gold Sunscreen. And yes, let's get started without further ado. So this is the Photo Stable Gold Sunscreen, and yes, I have used this for quite some time before coming up with this video. So here is my honest opinion on this sunscreen. Now obviously I have used Photo Stable Sunscreen ML Gel before, and these two are from the same brand. So this is meant for dry skin types, dry to normal skin types, and this is meant for oily skin types. So my skin falls in between, so I have a combination sensitive skin type, and hence I thought of trying this one because it was like very oily in between. So I thought of just trying this out and reviewing it for you guys. So this gives a matte finish. This is a sunscreen gel. This gives a dewy finish. This is more silicone based, so obviously you will get a matte finish. And yes, this is SPF 55. This is 40+, and this has PA triple plus. This has also PA triple plus. So that was all about the differences. And yes, both of these have good chemical ingredients, the good sunscreen filter. At the same time, oh boy, you blow my mind. I don't know whether both of these are tested thoroughly in the lab or not, because they have not replied to my email, so I am not sure about that. But coming to this one, now I have obviously discussed about this long back, and I have made two videos on this one on my channel. Links will be mentioned in the description box below for your reference. Now coming to this one, this obviously has cyclopentaxyloxane and dimethicone cross polymer and dimethicone cross polymer. So all these are silicone based ingredients, which gives a matte finish, and this is without any oil. So obviously this is for oily skin types and gives a matte finish, as I've already told. Now this has BHT, which is butylated hydroxy toluene, as a preservative, which is a cheap preservative. However, this one doesn't have BHT. There are better alternatives to those. Now coming to my experience of using this sunscreen, I had a very good experience in the first 1 week, and I was not applying any moisturizer before applying this one. So in that week it fared quite well, and I didn't have any issue with it. When it comes to the second week, my skin was turning a bit sensitive, and I have shared about the sensitivity, but it was in the starting and I was not aware that it was due to sensitivity. But when I applied the sunscreen on one fine day, I ended up getting like balls like formation on my face on either side of my cheeks, and it was turning out to be very, very messy. It was itching, it was irritating, it was very painful, and obviously I ended up getting spots in the long run because of this. This just irritated my skin so much, and especially if you are sensitive skin, I think you shouldn't ever try this sunscreen, as my sensitivity to such an extent that I was almost depressed for quite some time because of the skin issues. Okay, after that I stopped using the sunscreen obviously, but after that again, after my skin recovered, I tried using the sunscreen and I ended up getting one or two breakouts. It was not like the one which I had previously, but it was still a breakout and I didn't like that. So whenever I pair it with any moisturizer, it has given me breakout. And yes, please don't use this with the moisturizer. But yes, there's one exception. One group of people like this sunscreen and they have given positive feedback about this sunscreen, and there are few of you who have asked me to try out the sunscreen, and I tried out, but it was not suitable. So except for those set of people who like this one and who has been using this for years, I think the new ones, if you want to try out a new sunscreen, I think please don't go for this sunscreen, because I was literally pissed off after using this sunscreen on my sensitive skin. Though I like the matte finish of the sunscreen and I loved it when I didn't use any underlying moisturizer, but whenever I have used any underlying moisturizer or even a toner or an essence, I ended up getting pimples, and that is why I don't recommend this one. Also, this was used by my sister and she stays in Calcutta. You know, there you don't need to apply a moisturizer in the daytime because it's so hot and humid, and she didn't observe any such thing with this one because she was obviously, I think she didn't use any moisturizer. But yes, down the line I think she has got some close comedones. Now I am not sure whether she got it because of this or due to other environmental conditions, but yeah, she ended up getting some close comedones and she has been complaining of this, and she is trying to shift to a different sunscreen. But anyways, that was all about this video, and that was all about my review about this sunscreen. So whoever is using it and has been using it for quite some time, stick to it. Don't change your sunscreen just for the sake of me giving a review on it and me giving a negative feedback on it, because if it has suited you well, go ahead. And obviously every skin type is different, but this was my experience. So if you're planning to buy this one, Photostable Gold, I think please don't use it, especially if you are from the sensitive zone, please don't use it. I think this one fared much better, and that's how I came to know. Like when I first used this sunscreen in the first week, I was so very impressed by this. But in the second week, I had, my God, this is a bummer. And that's why I think that's why it's not so popular in YouTube, I guess. But anyways, I'll be using this on my body for sure, because I need to use this, and it was quite expensive. It was, so this was around 719. Obviously, I got some discount from NetMeds. But anyways, I don't like wasting my money on products which don't suit me, obviously, for obvious reasons. And yeah, I'll be using this on my body. So yeah, that was all about today's video. If you have stayed until this point, please don't forget to like this video. If you have liked it, you can also dislike it if you have not liked it. And also you could subscribe to my channel for more such videos. See you in my next video pretty soon. Bye.